Morning students, welcome back in history class, lesson number 2. Today we have to revise lesson number 2, that is India before the times of Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, and we will revise question number also. Question answers of this lesson. Now let us see, India before the times of Shivaji Maharaj. We shall learn about the various ruling powers in India before the times of Shivaji Maharaj. In this lesson, various ruling powers existed in India during that period. Okay, let us see the powers one by one. Dynasty, regional powers. Okay, now we are talking about regional powers. Dynasty, Par dynasty, region, Bengal, ruler Gopal and his were founder of the rule of the Pala dynasty. Okay, then number 2, Rajput, Gurzar, Katihar and Gadwal and Parmar. Their region, Central India, North India. Then Chauhan dynasty from North India, and the rulers was Prithviraj, and his work, he defeated Muhammad Ghori in the first war of Tarai, but was defeated in the second war of Tarai. Okay, then number 4, Chola dynasty. Chola region is related to Tamil Nadu, and the rulers was Rajraj first and Rajendra first, and their work conquered Maldives islands and Sri Lanka and had a strong army. Okay, then Hoysala dynasty. Hoysala dynasty, region Karnataka. Rulers Vishnu Varahardhan, and work conquered whole of Karnataka. Then Rashtrakut dynasty, and their region Maharashtra. Rulers Govind III and Krishna III. Govind III's work was empire from Kannauj to Rameshwar, and Krishna III's empire work was expanded empire up to Allahabad. Then number 8, Shilahar means 3 branches. North Konkan, Thane and Raigarh. South Konkan, Kolhapur, Sangli, Satara and Belgaum. And number 9, Yadav dynasty. Their region was in Maharashtra, and the rulers was Vilam Vip, and their work capital at Devagiri, expanded empire beyond Krishna river, golden era of Marathi language and literature, emergence of Mahanubha Panth and Warkari. Invasions from the northwest. Invasion means what? Invasion yani atrav. The invaders from the northwest conquered the local dynasties. The Arab general Muhammad bin Qasim conquered the Sindh province in the 8th century, overcoming the resistance of King Dahir. The Turks started invading India in the 11th century CE. Sultan Muhammad of Ghazni invaded India many times. India ko giradana aur uske upar akraman karna. Theek hai? He plundered yani lootpaat machana. He plundered the rich temples of Mathura, Vrindavan, Kannauj and Somnath. Now the Delhi Sultanate. Sultan Muhammad Ghori invaded India from 1175 CE to 1178 CE. He appointed Qutubuddin Aibak to govern the conquered territory of India. After the death of Ghori in 1206 CE, Aibak began to rule independently. The Delhi Sultanate ruled India up to 1526 CE. Ibrahim Lodi was the last ruler. He was defeated by Babur in the first battle of Panipat. The significant among the rulers of Delhi Sultanate were Iltutmish, Rajia, Balban, Alauddin Khilji, Mohammeduddin Tughlaq, Firuz Tughlaq and Ibrahim Lodi. Okay, now the Kingdom of Vijayanagara. Taking advantage of revolts against the Tughlaq Empire, Harihar and Gupta founded the Kingdom of Vijayanagar in 1336 CE in the south. Hampi was the capital of the kingdom. Harihar was succeeded by Gupta. He spread his kingdom up to Rameshwaram. Krishna Dev Rai ascended the throne in 1509 CE. He conquered Vijayawada and Rajahmundry. He defeated the combined armies of sultans under Bahmani Sultan Muhammad Shah. Krishnadev Raya's kingdom extended from Cuttack in the east up to Goa in the west and Raichur Dob in the north up to the Indian Ocean in the south. Now, Hazar Ram temple and Vittam temple were built during his region. Now the Bahamani kingdom. Hassan Gangu Sardar, a dependent of the Muhammad Tughlaq, founded the Bahamani kingdom in 1347 CE. Gulbarga in Karnataka was the capital of Bahamani kingdom. Muhammad Gawan was the chief wazir and he strengthened the Bahamani kingdom. He introduced many reforms, brought discipline in the army and opened madrasas after the death of Gawan. Due to conflicts among Sardars, the Bahamani kingdom disintegrated and five small kingdoms emerged. They were Himad Shahi of Barad, Barid Shahi of Bidar, Adil Shahi of Bijapur, Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar, and Qutub Shahi of Golconda. Now, the Mughal power. The Mughal power in India was founded by Babur in 1526 CE by defeating Ibrahim Lodi in the first battle of Panipat on 21st April 1526. Okay. Prior to founding of the rule of the Mughal dynasty, Babur was the king of Fargana in Uzbekistan, Central Asia. He defeated Rana Sangas of Mewat in Kannauj. Babur died in 1530. Humayun was the successor of Babur. He was defeated by Sher Shah. Sher Shah founded the Sur dynasty, and however, Humayun managed to restore the Mughal rule in 1555 CE. Now, Maharana Pratap. Maharana Pratap became the ruler of Mewar after Uday Singh. He opposed Akbar's imperialistic policy, and he is known for his qualities like valor, courage, self-respect, and sacrifice. Then Chand Bibi. Chand Bibi, the daughter of Husain Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar, bravely defended the port of Ahmednagar from the Mughals in 1595 CE. Due to interval strife between the Sardars of Nizam Shah, Chand Bibi was murdered. Now Rani Durgavati. Rani Durgavati, daughter of Chandel Rajput dynasty, became queen of Gondwana after marriage. She laid down her life while fighting Akbar, but did not surrender. Surrender yani sharan jaan. Wo akbar tak ladti gayi, lekin wo sharan nahi gayi. Akbar ko. Then Aurangzeb. So Jahangir succeeded Akbar as the Mughal emperor in 1605 CE. Jahangir's wife Nur Jahan played an active role in administration. Shah Jahan succeeded Jahangir in 1628 CE and ruled India till his death in 1658. Aurangzeb was the last noteworthy Mughal emperor who ruled India from 1658 CE to 1707 CE. Then Oms, the people of Shan community who settled down in the valley of river of Brahmaputra were known as Oms. The Oms, under the leadership of Gandhar Singh and Commander Lachit Borphukan, gave intense fight to the Mughals. Due to the guerrilla technique of Oms, the Mughals could not create a strong base in Assam. Now the six. Guru Tej Bahadur protected against the policy of religious intolerance of Aurangzeb. He was imprisoned and beheaded in 1675 CE. Guru Gobind Singh organized the Sikh youths into Khalsa Dal to fight with Aurangzeb. However, they did not succeed. Later, Guru Gobind Singh succumbed to his wounds in Nanded. Then last one is Rajput. Sultan was routed after the death of Rana Jaswant Singh fought against the Mughals for the Sardarjah of Mewat. Okay, here our revision is over. And now let us see question answers. Number one, name the following. Queen of Gondwana, Rani Durgavati, son of Uday Singh, Maharana Pratap, founder of the Mughal dynasty, Babur, the first Sultan of Bahamani kingdom, Hassan Gangu, and the fighting force established by Guru Gobind Singh, Khalsa Dal. Next one is capital of the Yadav dynasty, Devagiri, was defeated in the second battle of Tarai, Prithviraj Chauhan, Sultan of Ghazni Muhammad, then a slave who became a Sultan, Qutbuddin Aibak. Pahle ye jo Qutbuddin Aibak tha, wo general secretary tha, lekin baad mein wo rajgaddi pe baith gaya. Theek hai? Became the king of Vijayanagar after Hariyat. Answer is book ka. Which was the famous dynasty in Bengal during the 8th century? Answer is Pal dynasty. Which of the following is not Rajput dynasty? And the answer is Rashtrakut. Okay. Whom did Prithviraj Chauhan defeat in the first battle of Tarai? Answer is Mohammad Ghori. Which Hoshiyal king brought the whole of Karnataka under his rule? Under his Vishnu Varaha Vardhan. And the last one, the navy of ruler of which royal dynasty conquered Maldive Islands and Sri Lanka? And the answer is Chola dynasty. Then, in which battle did Babur defeat Rana Sanga? Answer is Battle of Kannauj. Who was capable daughter of Hasan Nizam Shah? Answer is Chandbibi. Then, who led the homes in their guerrilla warfare against the Mughals? Answer is Lachit Borphukan. Then, Aurangzeb was engaged in conflict with which in the following? Answer is Durgadas Rathod. And the last one, which Sikh guru was beheaded by Aurangzeb? Answer is Guru Tegh Bahadur. Then, see, complete the following diagrams. Then the question is fragments of Bahamani Kingdom. Let us see the fragments. Fragments are kitne tukde hue Bahamani Kingdom ke to five tukde hue. Number one, Imad Shahi of Barad, Barid Shahi of Bidar, Aziz Shahi of Bijapur, Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar, and Kutub Shahi of Golconda. Okay? Then temples looted by Muhammad Ghazni, Mathura, Vrindavan, Kannauj, and Somnath. Okay. Now, here we stop good enough. And we will revise the remaining portion of this lesson, that is question answers, in the next period. In the next period, we will see the question answers. Okay. Now, here we stop. Bye-bye, take care. And don't forget to read the lesson and revise all the question answers.